Now at 10, WKYT News on the CW Lexington. Tonight, high school football season kicked off in the Bluegrass. Now one Central Kentucky team is honoring a player who was killed in a recent accident.
Construction halted on UK's campus today after human skeletal remains were found. What we know about the discovery.
And a string of attempted break-ins has left police warning homeowners in Danville.
This is WKYT News on the CW Lexington.
Good evening to you. I'm Amber Philpott.
And I'm Bill Bryant. So good to have you with us on this Friday night heading for the weekend. We've had another round of really, really nice weather today.
Yeah, and it could not have been any more perfect for the start of high school football tonight. First Alert meteorologist Ben Beddoes joining us tonight, taking a look at this weekend's forecast.
Yeah, I mean, it's just been a perfect night for high school football. Temperature is very comfortable. And take a look at them right now. We're already into the 60s for pretty much all of us. 66 in Lexington, 64 in Danville, 66 in Somerset, 67 in London, down to 61 in Mount Sterling, and 66 in Moorhead. So, yeah, has been just a very nice night out there. And we certainly have nothing on the radar across our area. It's pretty much just dead clear. And really, it's hard to find any kind of shower activity near us. Really, the closest to have that is well into New England, as we have this cool air that continues to push down into our area, keeping those comfortable temperatures in place thanks to high pressure. We do have a warm front, though, that is moving across the Midwest. That's going to impact us as we go into the next couple days, but not least immediately. But tonight, we're going to see lows fall down into the lower 50s, even some spots perhaps into the 40s. We got a low of 54 tonight for Lexington, Richmond, but it looked like Jackson, Maysville, Ashland. They go into the upper 40s tonight, so those typical cool spots are going to be looking to be at that level. But the headlines here as we go into the weekend, again, we're looking at a very cool night ahead. Heat is on the way, though, because you mentioned that warm front that we have. This can be moving across the Midwest. That's going to impact us. That's going to bring temperatures up. And, well, the nice weather was nice. We're going to have temperatures back up into the 90s next week, and it'll pretty much be all next week. But I'll have more info about that coming up.
Way leads on to way with that heat coming back. Thank you very much, Ben. Tonight, it was the first night of Friday night kickoff, but one Central Kentucky high school team is missing a very special player.
Yeah, tonight, East Jessamine High School held a moment of silence for a student who died over the weekend. 15-year-old Joseph Seagraves died in an accident. He died in a fall in Carter County. Seagraves was a sophomore. WKYT's Grayson Passmore was there tonight and shows us how the team made sure that he was on the field with them. It's our top story at 10.
It's finally that time of year again.
Oh, it's exciting. The first game,
yeah,
you know?
First game.
And we've known we've had it on the calendar for a while.
The bleachers are filled with fans. The cheerleaders have taken their places on the field. And the East Jessamine High School football team is ready to see what the night holds.
It's that same butterfly feeling in your stomach, and you've worked, you know, literally since last December. Whenever you put the pads up, you never quit thinking about it. Football is one of those things you do all year long. You don't do football, you live football.
Six practices a week, countless hours of preparation. It's all brought them to this night.
Just a lot of emotions coming at you at once with the expectations of what's this season going to be like. First games can be as emotional as anything you ever go through in your entire life.
And now at the start of this season,
if we could take a moment to remember Joseph Seagraves.
The team is missing one of their own.
We lost Joseph Seagraves last weekend, and it was just an unspeakable tragedy, just something you never want to go through.
At 15 years old, Joseph died from a fall in Carter County. His family would normally cheer him on from the stands. Instead, this time, they'll insist the team plays, even without him.
The family was very adamant, though, that we keep pushing on, and they know Joseph was a tough kid. You know, there's a Seagrave Strong kind of something we've adopted this week, and he would have wanted us to push on.
And that's what the team will do. But they're making sure Joseph is with them still through every play.
We're going to honor him with his initials on the back of our helmet with a black sticker. Joseph was not a quitter. He was a great kid. He came every day, gave it everything he had.
In Nicholasville, Grayson Passmore, WKYT.
We have not been made aware of any funeral arrangements for Seagraves just yet. His mother was also injured. She remains in critical condition in the hospital, and a GoFundMe has been set up to help the family.
Officials are looking into some human remains that were found at a University of Kentucky construction site today. Fayette County Coroner Gary Ginn advised UK's police chief, Joe Monroe, that the land may have been a burial ground in the past. And while the discovery is somewhat unsettling, Chief Monroe says the community is not at risk and no foul play is involved.
Those different items of human remains or other historical items is not really unusual to find. It's part of our history, and we turn all that over to the coroner's office or the historical society.
Chief Monroe says that due to the age of the bones, it is unlikely that the coroner will be able to identify who they were. And because the coroner says that he suspects the remains may be victims of cholera, we're looking into a large outbreak that happened in the city of Lexington back in 1833. According to historians, during a two-month period, nearly 500 people died, mainly in areas of Main Street, High Street, and Short Street. They say there were some unusually high temperatures that summer, and a vacant house where discarded organ meat was stored are both believed to have contributed to that outbreak.
A Henry Clay High School teacher was back in a Fayette County courtroom today. Kevin Lentz is currently on administrative leave from Henry Clay. He's accused of having explicit text conversations with a 9-year-old boy. Lentz is facing state and federal charges. He was in court today on those state charges. He waived his right to testify. A Fayette district judge then sent the case to a grand jury.
A man on the top 10 most wanted fugitives list in Texas was arrested in Lexington. According to the Texas Department of Public Safety, Daniel Noble was wanted for indecency with a child. He has been wanted by Texas authorities since February. Noble was set to appear in a Fayette County courtroom this afternoon, but that has been rescheduled to Monday.
We now know the charges against former Commonwealth's attorney Ronnie Goldie after his arrest earlier today. He faces 14 counts, including bribery and fraud. FBI agents in Moorhead arrested Goldie this morning. The FBI says Goldie will make his first court appearance next week. Goldie was impeached and convicted by the state Senate earlier this year. Lawmakers convicted Goldie of doing favors for a woman facing prosecution in exchange for nude photos.
Police are still investigating after they say a bomb was found in a home in Irvin last night. Marcus Spurgeon is currently in jail on unrelated charges. But the police chief says more charges are coming. Irvin police and the ATF were on the scene after Spurgeon's arrest led them to find several guns and a military-style explosive in the man's home. The situation wrapped up late last night, but neighbors were forced to leave their homes for hours. And they say it was a scary experience.
And then, you know, you get out and you think about it, your house might blow up, but then you think about the first responders and the people actually have to go in and get the bomb.
Police say the original warrant was for disorderly conduct and indecent exposure.
The state's attorney general's office is responding to a lawsuit filed against it alleging workplace discrimination. It comes after the Cameron campaign released a statement yesterday which did not address or deny the claims. Today's statement reads in part, quote, "The attorney general's office has the utmost respect for its employees and takes all complaints seriously. Here, the office investigated the complaints and found that three of the complaints mentioned lacked merit. Regarding the fourth complaint, a reprimand was issued," end quote.
The situation in Maui is still dire after those deadly wildfires. At least 111 people have died as a result of those fires, and officials say that number could rise even higher. We told you yesterday about Alexander Muto, who is from Lahaina and is now attending UK medical school. We talked with his mother today. She still lives in Maui and is now housing 22 people who have been displaced. She says it's a heartbreaking situation there with thousands still missing.
Children, there's a lot of children still missing, and now the kids are going to school and they're like, where are my friends?
The Muto family is collecting donations through their nonprofit organization, the Ignite a Life Foundation. You can find a link to that on WKYT.com. And you can join WKYT, Gray Television, and the Salvation Army in helping the people of Maui. To donate, scan the QR code that you see on your screen, or you can text Fire Relief to 51555. All designated gifts will go to those affected by the disaster.
New tonight, East End Day kicked off here in Lexington.
Tonight, it was old school dance and community meet and greet tonight, and that wrapped up, he was going to wrap up in a few minutes at about 11. Saturday is the second annual East End Arts and Music Festival. That festival will begin tomorrow afternoon at 3. The event will be filled with artists, live music, food vendors, and kids' activities, including the Kentucky Reptile Zoo. Admission to that is free. And then Sunday is a gospel explosion that will be held from 2 to 4 p.m.
Well, we have the nice temperatures across our area today, but coming up in a couple minutes, I'll talk about some heat building back in next week.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right. It's better than yours, I could teach you, but I have to charge.
$1.99 small classic shakes all day at Sonic.
No, 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 no.
Stop right there. This week at the Denny's Super Slam, starting at $7.99. Hungry for all your breakfast favorites? When you want America's biggest breakfast, starting at $7.99, at Denny's,
it's diner time.
Now open really late.
Just one drop.
Oh!
Gorilla Super Glue Micro Precise. Of course!
Precise application. Controlled dispensing with Gorilla Strength. For the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
Secure your home with Cornerstone Protection.
Hey, this is Captain Stone, and this is your 10 o'clock lock reminder. Close your blinds and arm your alarm. Secure your home with Cornerstone Protection.
The new 2023 GMC Sierra AT4X is equipped to conquer the great outdoors. Or the great indoors. Welcome to the peak of premium off-roading. Or get 0.9% APR plus over 3,200 total trade assistance and no monthly payments for 90 days on 2023 Sierra Denali 5.3-liter V8 light-duty models.
Keep moving, keep living. At ARH, our team is focused on returning you to your best quality of life by providing exceptional orthopedic care. Don't let bone or joint pain get you down. If you are injured or in need of a joint replacement, ARH offers a full range of services, from non-surgical to surgical. You are uniquely you, and your orthopedic care should be too. Return to a full and active lifestyle by visiting ARH.org to find an ARH orthopedic provider. ARH, more for Appalachia.
High-paying jobs are going unfilled. You can attend college for 4 years or more, or after a short time at the Building Institute, you could be working, while others are still struggling to pay back their tuition. The Building Institute's Fast Track Earn As You Learn low-cost education program can have you licensed in electric in 2 years or HVAC or plumbing in 1 year. The road to your career has a fast lane, so sign up at thebuildinginstituteky.com.
Don't miss this year's Tour of Remodeled Homes, August 26th and 27th, presented by Congleton Lumber, featuring a variety of projects by our BIA professional remodelers, such as J&R Construction and Mulberry Builders. Visit BIACentralKY.com for the details.
There comes a time in every dip's life when it's ready to leave the slow cooker, even buffalo chicken dip. So we put juicy chicken, buffalo sauce, and melty cheese in a portable crispy golden shell. Runaway dip, you're free now. Sonic $2.99 Buffalo Chicken Dip Bites.
And I've been here 25 years now, going on 26, and I know by now it's going to take all of us to solve the issues we face. They're too complex. We've got children issues. We've got parental issues because somebody knows but won't talk. Somebody knows but won't talk. And I understand that some that know are being threatened. But how long are we going to be held hostage? We need all of us to band together to step up and do what needs to be done. These are our sons. These are our daughters. We cannot afford to sit this one out. We can do better. With your help, we will do.
Closed captioning on WKYT is brought to you by Cumberland Valley National Bank. Bank better.
Well, it's just been a beautiful night across our area. Perfect night for the first week of high school football, first high school football games tonight. It's just, again, very perfect. You can't really ask for much better of an August night across the area. Take a look at the sky cam here in downtown Lexington. Things, again, are very quiet. And take a look at this temperature right now. We're at 66 degrees. That is not bad at all for a summer night. A calm wind. We have a dew point of 56. That just tells you that the humidity is rather low, especially for this time of year. And as we really look at the first alert radar, our network, we're seeing no activity across our area. We'll continue to really see that as we go, well, through the next several days. And really, it's hard to find any rain near us on the map. And the closest rain is generally into New England, where we're seeing low pressure across that area. For us, we're seeing this cool air continue to come in and bring that those comfortable temperatures due to the high pressure to the west of us. We do also have a warm front that is situated across the Midwest. This will shift east as we go through the next couple days. And that's going to bring our temperatures up as we go into next week. But really, as we look at tonight, again, temperatures are going to be very comfortable. We're going to be falling into the low 50s for most of us, even some spots of cooler spots into the upper 40s, 54 Lexington, 49 Jackson, 54 Richmond, 51 Mount Sterling, 49 Maysville, kind of the numbers we could see as we go into tomorrow morning. So very unusual for August. And then as we look really at the day, going to be very comfortable. We're going to have the warm temperatures return, but only up into lower 80s. Again, nothing here on the radar and not really too many clouds either. Now we'll go into Saturday night into Sunday morning. Very comfortable still. We'll be into the upper 50s to lower 60s. And then, though, we go into the day on Sunday, we are going to see temperatures. They're going to climb up into the upper 80s, maybe in a few 90-degree spots. So we are going to see certainly some changes as we go through the weekend. But it's still going to be looking like a pretty good weekend overall. So we look at the Emoji weekend forecast here. Looking good for tomorrow and looking good for Sunday, although it will be much warmer. But this number here, 88, that's going to be one of the lower numbers we see over the next couple days, because we have heat dome that is building generally to the west of us. This is going to expand eastward and impact us as we go into next week. And, well, that means we're going to have highs into the 90s all week. We'll build the humidity up as well. So as we go into Monday afternoon, it's going to feel pretty warm. But you can see the humidity is going to stay low through the weekend, and then it starts coming up on Sunday, especially into Monday and Tuesday here. That's where we're going to see certainly that humidity go up. And, well, it's going to feel more like the mid to upper 90s as we go into Monday afternoon. We'll see more of that as we go throughout the week. As we look at the 7-day forecast, things are going to begin. We'll have the mid-80s for Saturday, upper 80s for Sunday. We'll be into the low 90s as we go into really much of next week. Again, low to mid-90s, going to have that humidity around as well. So it's going to be it's going to feel about more like the mid to upper 90s to around 100 degrees potentially.
Just get ready for it, right?
It's going to be hot.
Yeah.
Hey, by the way, and again, welcome aboard.
Yeah, welcome aboard. Thank you.
You liking it around here so far?
Yes, I love it here.
Awesome. Right, very good. Thank you.
Meanwhile, 20,000 people are rushing to escape a wildfire near the capital of Canada's Northwest Territories.
The fire is threatening the city of Yellowknife, and officials have ordered all residents out of there. There's only one highway that leads out of town. Residents without cars waited in long lines to register for emergency flights.
We've never, ever seen a wildfire season like this. Nobody envisioned an event of this scale, and it was just, and it's still really stressful. There's a lot of people left in Yellowknife that are freaking out.
The Yellowknife fire is just one of 1,100 burning across Canada, including this blaze that is going on in a city in British Columbia not far from the U.S. border. The record number of fires has contributed to choking smoke and hazardous air quality, even in parts of the U.S.
Well, there will soon be a new little library in Lexington, and it's going to be outside Chevy Chase Inn. We're going to explain how it honors the memory of a longtime staple of the bar.
Made from scratch biscuits rising, hand-breaded chicken frying, 100% Angus beef burgers charbroiling. Just a few of the ways Hardee's handcrafts goodness in the making.
Astapro Allergy, steroid-free allergy relief that starts working in 30 minutes, while other allergy sprays take hours. With Astapro's unbeatably fast allergy relief, you can Astapro and go.
When migraine strikes, are the trade-offs of treating worth it? Ubrelvy is another option. It quickly stops migraine in its tracks. Do not take with strong CYP3A4 inhibitors. Allergic reactions to Ubrelvy can happen. Most common side effects were nausea and sleepiness. Ask about Ubrelvy.
When I came to ARC, my son was 2 months old. I had just recently relapsed, and I had never hit that kind of level of desperation that I had when I walked through those doors. I remember being very fearful of the unknown and what was to come. I found a family. I found friendships that will last me a lifetime. I found hope. My name is Caroline, and I find my recovery at Addiction Recovery Care.
Lexington 911 to me is the heartbeat of Lexington. We're the center. Whatever people need, we're here. You know, we answer from the smallest questions to the biggest questions and incidents.
I would recommend Lexington 911 for anyone looking for a career. One of the most rewarding things is the family, the extended family that you retain.
So I would definitely recommend it. The hours are good. The pay is good. The benefits. There's plenty of opportunity to grow and learn. You have like 3 different schedule shifts to choose from, and just the environment's great to be here.
Here at Hub Mechanical, we want our customers to know that we have their best interests at heart. None of our technicians are paid any commission for the parts that they sell you. Our goal isn't to sell you a lot of stuff you don't need, but to provide you exactly what you do need. That's the Hubbard way.
Are you between the ages of 45 and 75, uninsured or underinsured, and a Kentucky resident? If so, you may qualify for a free colonoscopy. Call Kentucky Cancer Link at 859-309-1700. To discover eligibility for your colon cancer screening. This program is funded by the Kentucky Colon Cancer Screening and Prevention Program. Screenings save lives, but only if you get tested. Call 859-309-1700.
They know all of your secrets.
I used to wet my bed.
Your middle name is Muriel.
I'm still Jesus' pediatrician.
Julie was in a porno movie.
You're the one who's having the affair with the guy who keeps the pigeons on the roof.
Secret affair.
But they love you anyway. Friends.
Weeknights at 7 on the CW Lexington.
When it comes to a lung cancer diagnosis, you need to know the facts. Fact, in the United States, over 25,000 black men and women are diagnosed with lung cancer each year. Fact, our community is more likely to develop advanced lung cancer than any other racial or ethnic group. Fact, lack of access to health care, lack of clear resources for help, and mistrust in the medical system are not helping us beat this. Fact, lung cancer continues to be the leading cause of cancer deaths among black men and women. But there is a way for us to take back control of our health. Learn all that you can about you or a loved one's cancer diagnosis and treatment options. Get more information on lung cancer, screening, and clinical trials by visiting standuptocancer.org/lungcancer today. Together, we can bring about real change, because fact, change is possible, and it starts with you.
Hardee's 2 for $5 breakfast bake goodness into your morning. Choose a biscuit with sausage and egg, biscuit and gravy, or French toast dips. Any two, just $5. Hardee's, goodness in the making. Get exclusive offers on the Hardee's app.
Welcome back in. Little libraries. You may have one in your own neighborhood. It is a free place to swap books. You often find them off the beaten path in communities. Tomorrow, Lexington's newest little library will be dedicated at in Chevy Chase, and it will sit outside a very unlikely place. In tonight's Commonwealth of Kindness, what one young girl built that serves as a lasting legacy to one very special man. Chevy Chase Inn in Lexington is a lot of things, both historic and eclectic. Number one rule, no politics in the bar, the sign front and center. But regulars here aren't just patrons.
You know, Amber, Chevy Chase Inn is a very, very unique bar in many, many ways. But yeah, one of it is just the family atmosphere that it is. And, you know, it's something you just really can't recreate. It truly is a family in here.
One of CCI's family members, though, is missing behind the bar. Russell Red Eye Salyer was a staple here, a part of the bar's rich history.
You know, he ran this bar for more than 40 years, and he was family to everybody that came in here. But to me, he was a mentor, and he was a friend.
Russell didn't just serve up drinks and listen to bar talk. He was an avid reader and became the founding father of something you wouldn't expect to find in a bar.
There was a library in the back room, and there was a shelf, and they would just all trade books back and forth, and it was a CCI library.
That's right. Russell served up bottles and books at CCI, and that's what owner Kevin Hethcote's 11-year-old daughter, Stella, remembers most about Russell.
He was a very avid reader. And he loved the bar and everybody in it.
Stella and Russell formed a special bond over their shared love of history books, but it was also deeper.
He was like my grandpa. And I remember on Saturdays when I was younger, my dad would be setting up the bar and I would play pinball with him in the back.
At the end of last school year, Stella had to complete a project. Inspired by a little library in her neighborhood, Stella set out to build her own. With the help of some bar patrons, she built a replica of a place special to her family, Chevy Chase Inn. The project became a way to honor her book-loving, bartending friend who was in poor health. In July, the man who made books at CCI a thing sadly passed away.
I just think it'll be really cool for people to fill it with books. And I think he would love knowing that.
This little free library is now set to be dedicated to a man so many miss at their favorite watering hole. Over the years, this little dive bar on Euclid has seen a lot in its 90 years. But perhaps this new addition is the best yet. Owner Kevin Hethcote misses his dear friend, but couldn't think of a better way to see him live on at the bar.
Just to think that she wanted to do that, not only for a very special man, but for the neighborhood that she knows and loves and be able to provide books for Chevy Chase. It's just a great place and a great thing that she's done.
There's going to be a celebration of life for Russell Red Eye Salyer tomorrow at Chevy Chase Inn. It's happening from 11 to 2. It's also going to serve as a fundraiser for a place that Russell really loved, the bookseller in the Lexington Public Library. So donations will be taken tomorrow for Friends of the Public Library. And for more information, and if you'd like to go ahead and donate, you can do so. And if you find this story online right now. So don't be surprised the next time you go to CCI that there's also going to be a little library outside. I know it doesn't fit, but it's for a really good cause.
Really,
a sweet memory.
Imagine the stories that will be told tomorrow.
I know, right? Well, after a string of attempted break-ins, police are warning homeowners in Danville.
And state road workers finish completing a bridge connecting two Letcher County communities. Those stories and more on the way.
They definitely sent you a GIF.
It's pronounced GIF.
EV, plug-in hybrid, hybrid. To each their own, electric. Find yours at the Lexus Golden Opportunity sales event.
Get special offers on the 2023 ES300 Hybrid.
Many gravitate towards crystals for their beauty. Others find strength and energy from owning crystals. Whatever your reason, come to Kentucky Crystal Garden this Friday and Saturday from 11 to 3 for a relaxed, uplifting shopping experience or shop online.
If you're a Medicare beneficiary and live in the area, call now to see how this little card could get you some big benefits, including up to $900 added back to your Social Security check each year. With one toll-free call, you can find out how easy it is to get all of your original Medicare coverage, plus extra benefits. You get an all-in-one plan designed to fit your needs so you can be your best every day. You could have medical coverage, prescription drugs with $0 generics, dental, vision and hearing, plus the WellCare Visa Flex card to pay for extra dental, vision and hearing expenses, money for over-the-counter items, and up to $900 back in your Social Security check each year. And so much more. And here's more good news. You can get a WellCare plan for a $0 monthly premium. How can WellCare offer all of those benefits for a $0 monthly premium? It's simple. Medicare Advantage and Medicare Part D prescription drug coverage are important parts of Medicare. WellCare has a contract with Medicare to offer and provide these important options to you. Call right now to get your free copy of the WellCare All-in-One Guide. Call 1-866-907-3176 now. There is absolutely no obligation for requesting this free information. WellCare offers benefits that go beyond the basics, including up to $900 each year added to your Social Security check to help cover your Part B premium. Call today to get your free copy of the All-in-One Guide with absolutely no obligation. Your free plan guide will provide information to make a smart choice for your Medicare coverage. Just call 1-866-907-3176. Remember, there's no obligation for requesting this free information. So call 1-866-907-3176. Call today. WellCare. Medicare done well.
This Sunday, watch The Chosen at 8, 7 Central.
Hey, stop, stop, stop.
Found it.
There's no such thing as out of bounds. Find adventure at the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event.
Get 3.99% APR financing on the 2023 RX350.
This is WKYT News on the CW Lexington.
Good evening once again. Welcome back. As the news continues, we're now approaching 10:30, and we have enjoyed a week of fall-like weather here in the Bluegrass today, especially nice.
Yeah, but summer is knocking on the door and ready to make a return. First Alert meteorologist Ben Bedos is tracking the warm-up for us.
Yeah, I mean, you walk outside tonight, it's like... Is it really August? I mean, it doesn't feel like it. Very comfortable out there right now. Temperatures are into the 60s, 66 in Lexington, 61 in Danville, 64 in Somerset, 67 in London, 63 in Georgetown, and 65 degrees in Frankfurt. And overall, the dew points are low, too. That's why we have basically temperatures falling into the 50s overnight. Overnight lows tonight going to be into low to mid 50s, and then even a couple spots may fall into the upper 40s. So it is going to be quite a cool night out there. And as we look at headlines, well, we're looking at look at the forecast here. We'll start out in the 50s, climbing up into the 70s throughout the day, and we'll top out in the low to mid 80s. But heat, it is on the way. I'll detail more of that coming up.
And it's serious.
Yeah.
All right, Ben, thank you very much.
Well, homeowners in Danville are making sure that their doors are locked tight tonight after a string of attempted break-ins.
Police say someone tried to break into three homes late last night. It was in an area of Old Shakertown Road. Well, new tonight, WKYT's Alyssa Williams has talked with police there about how you can make sure you and your family stay safe.
The Danville community is still searching for answers following a string of break-ins that took place Thursday night.
One of the homeowners whose home was targeted was David Chenault. He says he had just went to sleep when the burglar kicked his door in.
I just got the lights off and went to sleep and heard a thump, two big thumps, and got up and came in the living room, turned all the lights on.
Chenault says when he got to his front door, someone had drove off in a white SUV.
I was just angry. I was highly upset.
Danville Police Sergeant Aaron Rainwater says officers are still trying to gather more information on the suspect, but they do believe they may be a teen.
No one was able to give any kind of identifying factors. The first call couldn't even advise if it was male or female. All they could advise that it was going to be a Caucasian person. So
Rainwater says the department has flooded the area with patrol units, but he still advises everyone to keep an eye out for suspicious activity.
The important thing is just make sure your doors are locked, your vehicle doors are locked, your home doors are locked. And it's important if you have alarm systems, set those alarm systems. Even if you can't get to the phone to call 911, those alarm systems will alert us.
In Danville, Alyssa Williams, WKYT.
And Sergeant Rainwater says if anyone in the Danville area hears anything regarding this case that can help them identify the person behind those break-ins, he urges them to call the Danville Police Department.
The Colson Civic Center in Letcher County is working to lift the voices of those impacted by last July's flooding. The event was called Wind Mountains Cry. An attorney from West Virginia was there to help people fill out surveys about the waterways around their homes. Elaine Tanner, founder of Friends for Environmental Justice, says making sure people are prepared when flooding happens again will be life-changing for some.
There's people still in campers, so we want to reach out to them to show them that there's a possibility of some help if we, you know, stand together and we take these next steps in getting a survey completed.
Well, if you are interested in learning more or interested in completing one of those surveys, you can stop by the Colson Civic Center to pick up a packet.
And more than 1 year after the flood, state road workers have finally completed a bridge connecting the Neon and the McRoberts communities of Letcher County.
Chandler Wilcox tells us how the new bridge is making a difference to those living in the area.
Community members had to create a makeshift bridge after the flood took the original one out, and a lot of other things with it.
It was cars, trees, rocks, debris, and the collapse of the old bridge. So it was full.
After 6 months and 350 yards of concrete, a new bridge is now built.
I never would have dreamed it would have been that fast, but they took care of it, and that was impressive.
Barker says the bridge is better than the one destroyed by floodwater.
Well, it'll handle more water, and the bridge is now turned on a different angle than what the old bridge was, so that lets the water go straighter, you know, if you can imagine that, because it's on like a 45 now, it's on like a 33, so that helps out the angle and don't put no pressure on each side of the bridge.
Crews also filled in Barker's yard, which was torn up by the flood. He plans to build a garage around that spot.
I've got vehicles. I've got old cars and trucks and a place to play, hide my stuff.
With a wider bridge able to take on more water, Barker says the community feels safer living where they are.
And that was Chandler Wilcox reporting. Barker also says the bridge was funded through state programs, but the community is hoping another bridge in town can be repaired as well.
July rent increases in Lexington outpaced the increases in New York City. A report from Apartment List says Lexington ranked second among the 100 largest U.S. cities for month-over-month increases. It also far outpaced the national average of 0.3%. In July, Lexington rents rose 1.6%. The Herald Leader reports rent hub data shows the zip codes 40503 and 40509 saw the fastest growth. Jersey City is the only city in the country that passed Lexington.
COVID hospitalizations across the nation have increased 4 weeks in a row, and while case numbers are still relatively low compared to last summer's surge, health officials are still encouraging people to stay vigilant as students across the region head back to school. Kentucky River District Public Health Director Scott Lockard says there are some spots in our region that are seeing particular increases in COVID cases.
Letcher County has got a big uptick in cases. Owsley County's got a big uptick in cases. As does Wolf County. So we're seeing, you know, increase in cases throughout the district overall, but those three areas seem to be the hot spots for us right now.
Lockhart says the guidance on COVID isolation is still 10 days unless you test negative and are without symptoms then it's five days.
The Kentucky Transportation Cabinet says they will resurface two roads in Lexington next week. On Monday, Johnston Road will be closed for resurfacing from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. The Cabinet says drivers can take Muir Station Road instead. And on Tuesday, they will be resurfacing Spur Road from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. The Transportation Cabinet says drivers will be able to pass through that work zone. Both projects are expected to take just one day to finish.
Well, everyone is set up for the 47th annual Woodland Art Fair happening in Lexington.
It's an event where people can find unique handmade pieces and gifts. The assistant director of the Lexington Art League says you should try to come earlier in the day if you want to beat the heat and make sure you grab a unique piece of their own before they all sell out.
There's a nice intimacy, and it's very easy in one afternoon to visit all of the artist booths and be able to talk to everybody and see all the art.
The festival will run from 10 to 6 tomorrow and from 10 to 5 on Sunday. WKYT will also be there, so stop by and say hi. We'll have a booth, and some of us will be hanging out. We'll be glad to see you.
The man accused of killing four University of Idaho students last year appeared in court today to discuss his alibi and several other outstanding legal issues. The details when we return.
I know this looks like a summer blockbuster, but this is a Nissan sales event ahead.
Now get a low 419 per month lease on Rogue.
Better hurry. These offers won't get a sequel.
With the cost of everything going up, the last thing we need are high repair bills and high utility bills. It is never too late to have your heating and air serviced, cleaned, and inspected. Call us at Comfort Master Heating and Air.
Don't miss this year's Tour of Remodeled Homes, August 26th and 27th, presented by Congleton Lumber, featuring a variety of projects by our BIA professional remodelers, such as J&R Construction and Mulberry Builders. Visit BIACentralKY.com for the details.
My kids think I'm lame, but they don't know the real me.
They don't know that I'm into anime. They don't know that I used to be goth. But they're about to find out my passion for...
The Scrambler!
The Kentucky State Fair is August 17th through 27th. Buy your tickets online and get free parking. Go to kystatefair.org.
Am I going to lose a child because of this?
The all-new Investigate TV Plus is all about real solutions. Stories that impact you.
It really kind of took my breath away for a second.
Watch Investigate TV Plus weekdays this September on WKYT.
I know this looks like a summer blockbuster, but this is a Nissan sales event to have.
Get 0% financing for 36 months on select road trends.
Better hurry. These offers won't get a sequel.
The WKYT First Alert Weather App, alerting you first to inconvenient weather, tracking storms live, and bringing you hour-by-hour forecasts wherever you are. Download the WKYT First Alert Weather App today.
The Idaho man accused of killing four University of Idaho students late last year spent a day in court.
Brian Kohlberger's lawyers and prosecutors debated his alibi and other legal issues as his trial is now 6 weeks away. Emily Smith reports on the strategies unfolding in this high-profile death penalty case.
In a Friday lead-up to Brian Kohlberger's trial, one of the biggest questions is, where was Kohlberger the night four University of Idaho students were fatally stabbed in an off-campus house last November? Kohlberger's lawyers say they have an alibi.
The defendant filed notice that he is seeking an alibi. He will have an alibi that he was not in that house that night when the murders were committed.
Prosecutors want specifics. Who can back it up? In response, the defense says he was on a drive alone late at night, as he often did, stating Kohlberger is not claiming to be at a specific location at a specific time. At this time, there's not a specific witness to say precisely where Mr. Kohlberger was at each moment.
You can't respond to something that isn't real. Sorry, Judge.
DNA could play a key role in the case, as prosecutors have filed court documents calling Kohlberger's DNA a statistical match to a knife sheath found at the crime scene. A not guilty plea has been entered on Kohlberger's behalf to the murders which dominated headlines for the 7 weeks investigators searched for a suspect. The criminology graduate was arrested at his parents' home in Pennsylvania in January. He waived his right to a speedy trial, tightening all legal timelines.
One of the big issues is this trial, this death penalty trial, it's supposed to start in about a month and a half.
A gag order continues in the case so neither side can talk to the media, putting even more focus on what will be said in the upcoming trial. I'm Emily Schmidt reporting.
The high school football season kicked off tonight. Lee Kay is going to have your highlights coming up in sports.
Hey, we have a nice weekend ahead, but so going tomorrow, next week, temperatures on the rise.
Happy Baby here at Surplus Sales. We have flooring that's 100% waterproof. That's right, waterproof. In stock and ready to take home today. Now that will make you happy, like me. Surplus Sales in Corbin, Kentucky.
Whoa! Holy mackerel!
Play the Kentucky Lottery online, anywhere, anytime.
Astapro Allergy. Steroid-free allergy relief that starts working in 30 minutes, while other allergy sprays take hours. With Astapro's unbeatably fast allergy relief, you can Astapro and go.
When migraine strikes, are the trade-offs of treating worth it? Ubrelvy is another option. It quickly stops migraine in its tracks. Do not take with strong CYP3A4 inhibitors. Allergic reactions to Ubrelvy can happen. Most common side effects were nausea and sleepiness. Ask about Ubrelvy.
The name that defines the very best. Jimmy Nash Homes is building on your lot or in one of your communities with new floor plans featuring Anderson Windows and Doors, the most trusted name in windows and doors. See it all at jimmynashhomes.com.
If you are uninsured and need to be screened for colon cancer, you may be eligible for a free test. Call Kentucky Cancer Link at 859-309-1700.
Hi, this is Joseph with Rapid Fire Home Buyers. Do you have a house that's costing you too much time and money? Maybe a rental house, an inherited house you don't know what to do with, or the house you're living in that you just can't keep up with. We buy property in any condition and any price range all over the Southeast. Sell your house as is for cash with no repairs, no fees, and no commissions. If you're even thinking of selling your house, before you call a realtor, give us a call for a free cash offer. Call 859-695-3875.
At Rally's, I'm in the driver's seat. Let me get a $5 meal deal with a Rally burger. Hold up, make it a bacon cheddar crisp. Cheesy, yes pleasey, plus chicken bites, famous seasoned fries, and a drink for just $5. Actually, give me that cheddar Buford. Let's go. I'm talking cheese from top to bottom. Cheddar, better. Whatever you order, own it at Rally's. Get your late night flavor fix.
Bud's Gun Shop and Range offers the largest selection of firearms, ammunition, and firearm accessories in Kentucky. Shop handguns, shotguns, and rifles from all major manufacturers. Experience our indoor temperature-controlled shooting range, too. Visit Bud's Gun Shop in Lexington.
The Goldbergs, weekdays at 5 on the CW Lexington.
Happy Baby here at Surplus Sales. We have kitchen and bath cabinets in stock and ready to take home today. And they're all wood. Now that would make anybody happy, like me. Surplus Sales Flooring in Corbin, Kentucky.
We've all seen it. A social media post or video where your first thought is that true? Unfortunately, misinformation comes in many forms, but there are tools to help you spot those red flags. That's why WKYT and our corporate company, Gray Television Group, are teaming up with MediaWise, a literary initiative for the nonprofit Poynter Institute. Learn how to navigate through the social media noise and identify factual information. Scan the QR code now to find out more and sign up for daily text messages to become MediaWise.
Am I going to lose a child because of this?
The all-new Investigate TV Plus is all about real solutions. In-depth reports that reveal all sides. Stories that impact you.
Real people, real problems.
Real life solutions.
Investigate TV Plus, weekdays starting September 11th on WKYT.
The Kentucky Lottery, over $4.8 billion in grants and scholarships.
Well, this is a beautiful night across our area. Very comfortable temperatures out there. Not what you would typically see in August. Numbers right now widespread in the 60s. We have some spots already down into the lower 60s as well. Let's take a look at the numbers right now. It is 66 degrees in Lexington, 63 in Georgetown. We are 64 in Elizabethtown, 67 right now in London, 63 in Somerset, and 61 degrees in Monticello. So certainly it's just very comfortable out there, at least right now. And really that's partially because we really have dew points that are on the low side. We're seeing those dew points in the 50s, maybe to right around 60 degrees. And you don't typically see that in August, at least too much, but we got it now. And well, that's kind of why we're seeing temperatures have really taken a tumble tonight. As we look at the First Alert radar network, clear as can be across the area. Our nearest rain really is to the northeast of New England, seeing at least some rain showers right now. But overall, we have this cool air continuing to push into our area right now, and then high pressure to the west of us as well, and that's helping bring that cooler air in. We also do have at least a warm front that is trying to push across the Midwest, and that's going to eventually move into our area as well. That's going to bring that serious heat that we're going to have as we go into next week. But as we look at the weekend here, temperatures are going to start out really into the low 50s in the morning, some spots even into the upper 40s, really as we go through the week, at least the start of the weekend. We go through the day on Saturday, temperatures will climb back up into the upper 70s to lower 80s. And then as we go into tomorrow night, staying pretty comfortable, we'll have temperatures down into the upper 50s to lower 60s to start the day on Sunday. And then as we go into Sunday, temperatures will begin to heat up. They'll be up into the upper 80s, maybe even right around 90 degrees. But still overall here, very quiet as we go through the weekend, and then seeing temperatures fall a little bit Sunday night. But again, temperatures overall going to be on the rise. So as we look at really temperatures for tomorrow, starting out again, 55 degrees, cool, nice and cool. We'll be in the mid-70s by noon and then climbing up into low to mid-80s as we hit 5 o'clock, and still feel very comfortable. Certainly not much in terms of humidity. Then here comes the heat dome. High pressure situated to the west of us is going to eventually build in, and we are going to see temperatures basically all next week into the 90s. So it is going to be pretty hot overall. Humidity at least is going to stay down through the weekend, but you can see it climbs as we go through really next week. So not only is it going to be hot, but it's also going to be feeling pretty humid as well. And that means we're going to have temperatures feeling like the mid to upper 90s Monday afternoon to near 100 degrees. So We're going to see this a lot as we go through next week. As we look at the 7-day forecast here, we are going to be into the low to mid 80s as we go through Saturday, upper 80s on Sunday, and we'll fall through, at least we'll rise up into the low to mid 90s as we go into next week, and consistently we'll be in the low to mid 90s. So it's going to stay hot, and it's going to stay hot for some time. And we're also going to have those kind of those feel like temperatures into the upper 90s to around 100. Summer is not done yet.
Yeah, it we sounds remember like it's coming back with a vengeance, right?
Yes.
All right. Thank you.
Lee Kay joining us now with sports, and the Wildcats have some questions in their secondary heading into the new season.
Yeah, that's right, guys. You know, one of the biggest question marks for Kentucky's defense heading into the season is that secondary. Wildcats, they have plenty of young, talented players, but not a lot of experience. Junior Andrew Phillips, he's the old guy in the room, and he could be one of the Cats' most important defenders. The son of former Wildcat Carlos Phillips spent most of his time at nickel last season, and he will be counted on this season to match up against the opposing team's best receiver most weeks.
It's a lot of pride. You know, everyone tries to put their best, you know, their best slot defender out there who can guard. Usually the slot defenders are the receivers in the slot are ones you try to get the ball to on third down. So I feel like I take it highly that they put me out there to guard their best slot receiver on third down.
Now, one Wildcat in that secondary happy to be back preparing for football instead of constant rehab assignments is defensive back Jalen Geiger. The senior from South Carolina missed the majority of last season suffering a knee injury in the Florida game, but Geiger is back and he's showing what he can do without hesitation and thinking of that knee injury.
You know, I mentioned earlier about tackling. One of the things I was really pleased to see, he came out of the post and made an unbelievable open field tackle. That was awesome to see, and I think for his confidence, like, okay, I'm back. And you've seen him fly around, make plays, just like all our guys. You know, you're gonna have some mental mistakes where you get sort of back into it. But he's at the point in his career that as soon as it happens, he's like, yeah, I know I should have done this or that. So really pleased with his progress.
All right, high school football kicking off tonight. We're going to go to the Battle of Elkhorn Creek. It's a battle of the birds, Madison Southern, Scott County. It's been a minute since these two schools played each other on the football field. I can't think of the last time, in fact. Cardinals Red Heat attack comes out flying. Andrew Hickey looking up top to Eli Lilly. 28-yard touchdown pass, the first of this season, but not the last. After the Eagles turnover, Hickey to Lilly again. 13-0 birds. Southern just looking to get something going on offense on third and long. Luke Valencia is duck hunting. Coming down with the interception, Scott County back in business. That sets up this on the ensuing drive. Ali Hamadia from 6 yards out. It was all Scott County tonight, 51-7, the final. Now the nightcap of that BGO Battle of Elkhorn Creek. Franklin County, Great Crossing, Flyers punting on their first drive of the game. You know, sometimes the ball bounces your way, sometimes it doesn't. This time it does, if you're Franklin County. Off a Warhawk, recovered by the Flyers, setting up great field position. An easy Franklin County touchdown ensues. Flyers take a 7-0 lead. Franklin County's defense was tough as well tonight. Backing Great Crossing all the way back to their own goal line, forcing a safety. This one's still in the third quarter, and Franklin County leads 23-0. Now, that is just a small taste of all the high school football highlights we have here in Central Kentucky. Join myself and Brian Milam at 11 for more over on WKYT. We'll be right back.
WKYT Game Time is brought to you by UK Healthcare Orthopedics.
Girls like you aren't runners, they said. Well, I wasn't.
Let's go ahead and get some pictures of that knee, okay?
6 months, down the drain. Give up.
Keep the rhythm going.
Or get up.
Perfect.
Who's not a runner now?
You don't have to be an elite athlete to be treated like one. UK Healthcare Orthopedic Surgery and Sports Medicine. The power of advanced medicine.
Feels good to be home.
Ashley's Labor Day preview is going on now. This week, buy one, get one 50% off store-wide. Plus, update any room in your home for only $5.98 or get 0% interest for 60 months. Going on now at Ashley.
Well, it's morning. What a lazy Sunday morning. Oh,
the breezes sway low. And the blues are singing out.
Stop right there. This week at the Denny's Super Slam, starting at $7.99. Hungry for all your breakfast favorites? When you want America's biggest breakfast, starting at $7.99, at Denny's,
it's diner time.
Now open really late.
Just one drop. Oh!
Gorilla Super Glue Micro Precise. Of course!
Precise application. Controlled dispensing with Gorilla Strength. For the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
Big trucks can cause big wrecks.
I'm attorney Darrell Isaacs, the hammer. Big truck wrecks don't just happen with 18-wheelers. Delivery trucks like this have caused thousands of accidents. And when dump trucks like this lose control on the highway, the consequences can be deadly. So if you've been injured by a dump truck, delivery truck, 18-wheeler, or any kind of big truck, I'll fight to get you every dollar you deserve.
Big truck wreck, call 877-ALL-7.
One call, that's all.
Tired of being in the gym all week with no results? Tried every known weight loss solution and getting nowhere? Ageless has the fix. Semaglutide is an FDA-approved weight loss solution. Call the Ageless Center today for a free semaglutide consultation. 859-335-1330.
Feels good to be home.
At Ashley's Labor Day Sale Preview, get $1,000 off any size Sealy Princeton mattress. Or get 0% interest for 60 months on top mattress brands. Plus, get a free Yeti cooler with qualifying purchases. Only at Ashley.
We've all seen it, a social media post or video where your first thought is that true? Unfortunately, misinformation comes in many forms, but there are tools to help you spot those red flags. That's why WKYT and our corporate company, Gray Television Group, are teaming up with MediaWise, a literary initiative for the nonprofit Pointer Institute. Learn how to navigate through the social media noise and identify factual information. Scan the QR code now to find out more and sign up for daily text messages to become MediaWise.
We'll be over on WKYT very shortly for the news at 11. Hope you'll follow us over. East Jessamine High School is honoring a member of the football team who died in an accident. How his memory is living on. Danville police sending out a warning after they say they received multiple calls about attempted break-ins last night. And it is the first WKYT game time of the season. Lots of highlights coming up at 11 over on WKYT.
Ben comes to work for us and we get amazing weather. So thank you for being here for this great weather.
Yeah,
buddy.
I definitely brought the good weather. I didn't bring next week's weather.
Okay. Yeah.
But we're looking at hot temperatures returning for next week. Humidity up into the, I feel like temperatures in the upper 90s to around 100, so I'll detail that more over on WKYT.
We'll blame Chris Bailey for that.
Jim Caldwell for any bad weather. We always do. We'll see you shortly, everybody, on WKYT.
This is a story about purpose. This is a story about progress, about building on our past accomplishments and investing in innovation. All of this, combined with our industry-leading insurance, competitive pay rates, and flexible scheduling, is the reason why now is the time to join our team. This is our story. Let it be your story.